Hello and welcome to the NHL Network's countdown of the 50 most bizarre moments in NHL history. I'm Jameson Coyle. Hockey is a sport filled with rich tradition and rooted history. But over the next 60 minutes, we'll highlight the odd, unusual, and flat-out bizarre moments this great sport has ever seen. We start our countdown at number 50 with an own goal you need to see to believe.
Pezzik gaining the line. He takes a shot. Rebound!
Hansel tries for it, it falls right in the back of his pants, and watch this. It's laying in his pants, and he's going to take it right there, right into the net. You can see the puck laying on the top of his pants, on his jersey, in the net.
After reviewing the play, the puck did cross the line. We have a good goal.
To the point for Sharp, and now Keith back across to Sharp. Here is Taves for Kane, saved by Anderson, and then it's knocked in. The Blackhawks win in overtime. Andrew Shaw.
Oh my goodness! Wow, that is incredible. He headbutts it in. What a soccer play!
Shaw with the header. Have you ever seen that, Joe?
No.
The Chicago first to deliberately headbutted the puck in the net, no goal.
Perrier over to get it. Matvichuk checks him. Now Belanger falls backward. A pass in front to Gretzky, scores!
Tipped in front, his first goal, and the Kings have a 2-0 lead.
It hits the goaltender, then high on the body. It may be the head of Stu Grimson. The Kings don't care how it goes in. 2-0 LA.
Well, a nice header by Grimson. He reached up to the side of his helmet, and the puck was in. His first goal of the year.
Losing by 4 goals in the third period, Oilers coach Craig McTavish took his frustrations out on Harvey the Hound, Calgary's lovable mascot. Harvey may have lost his foot-long red tongue in the act, but McTavish and his Oilers could not silence the flames. Calgary edged Edmonton 4-3 with Harvey cheering all the way. Devils head coach Jim Schoenfeld and referee Don Koharski got into an argument following Game 3 of the 1988 Wales Conference Finals, and it continued into the tunnel.
Suspended Jim Schoenfeld, the coach. And Schoenfeld said, you can't suspend me. Simply, I'm going to coach. And they said, you coach, we don't referee.
We have now got word. Here come the officials now. We'll be doing tonight's game. And you'll hear the fans here. Welcome them, I'm sure. Look at this. Different uniforms, but they're going to do tonight's Stanley Cup playoff game. Can you believe now?
And we ought be a lot more concerned about getting this Stanley Cup playoff game on under the right circumstances than getting it on under the wrong. And these are the wrong circumstances.
Our countdown of the 50 most bizarre moments rolls on after this.
I've seen it all.
Unbelievable!
Absolutely incredible.
Roll the highlight film!
I don't think I've ever seen a goal like that.
These hands are set. Dangalicious!
Absolutely off the charts!
Those were some of the greatest goals we've ever seen. Great won't get you spot on this countdown, though. Only the bizarre and we keep the countdown moving with play number 44.
4:30 left to play in the period. Ottawa trying to tie the game. Dumped in from center ice. Tapping at that was Comrie. He didn't move it too far. And then the Ducks get it up to center, and Moan shot it deeper. Phillips. Look out. And there he got it in his own net. He did. Oh, my goodness, what a play. Oh, my goodness.
Phillips decides to come out on the same side that Emery comes out, and Emery has no idea where Phillips is or going with the puck. And it goes off Phillips' stick by Emery.
The clock froze for nearly 20 seconds. And they did nothing with the clock. Koivu wins the draw. Ellis hustles to the bench as Perry brings it into the Nashville zone. Throws a bouncing puck. It's in! A bouncing puck, I think, again, another own goal off a Nashville defender.
Ryan Suter kicks it into the top of the net.
It went off the crossbar and in. That's the second goal that's gone in off of Suter.
Look out now. Corey Perry just lofts it. Watch Suter. Hacky sack. Right off the crossbar and into the net. And it's a one-goal game all of a sudden.
And Suter can
seen that happen before.
Wow. And only his second game with the New York Rangers. A chance to win it for New York in the shootout against Fleury. Boyle in on goal. Where's the puck? It's in the net. He scores. The Rangers win.
Yeah, it went off the goal post initially. You couldn't tell there. But from my side, it looked like it went off the post. And he double hit it. We got to replay this, guys. Hey, this I don't think this game should be over. He double hit this puck. Watch this. One, and he hit it in again. It should be no goal. You got to take that back. That's not a goal.
The Ranger player shoots the puck, hits the post, goes back off the Ranger player, and the net is a double hit and no goal.
Rick Nash, leading goal scorer in the National Hockey League, in on Fleury. Nash to the back end, and Fleury makes the save. The Penguins get the extra point.
Oh, my!
Malik now.
6'6", 238, not a noted goal scorer, but he's going to give it a shot here.
Malik has not scored this year. In on Kolzik. Fake Malik! Oh, Malik went between his legs! And the Rangers win it in a shootout!
I've seen it all. I've seen it all.
Unbelievable!
It was a circus shot. I don't believe what I saw. Watch this. Through the legs.
Oops. Oh, are you kidding?
They just showed the replay on the board. The place is erupting again. Oh, I don't believe what
are
I just saw.
Are you kidding me?
Six.
He hadn't scored this year.
Look at him.
I got it. No problem.
Pushing Bobby Ryan. Stick back towards
him. Lubman with a shot.
Ryan scores.
And give an assist to the Etman. Because the stick was right there for Ryan to pick up.
I've never seen that in my life.
That was something.
I have to be honest. That was absolutely bizarre. And Bobby Ryan has no stick in his hand right now. But Antti Mäntinen was nice enough to push it over towards him. There it is at his feet so that he could pick it up. And when the rebound came his way, he says, thank you very much.
McCarthy with a hit on Terrence Farnsworth, take it away through the net, goes, and they score! McKenna followed in, McCarthy scores, and Cairns hit McCarthy! Fleury skating around, yelling at somebody, oh, he's yelling at Cairns in the penalty box.
We're not going. Oh, the rivalry's back, Sam.
Uh-oh.
The rivalry's
it's heating up now.
After the break, the great one appears with a great spelling blunder. You won't want to miss it.
They score for Los Angeles Kings.
Yes,
the Rangers are the champions.
The only thing that
Welcome back to the NHL Network's countdown of the 50 most bizarre moments in NHL history.
The Oilers have won the Stanley Cup. He's got to be feeling on top of the world now.
Wayne Gretzky, for the fourth time in 5 years, hoists it over his head.
Shoots, he scores!
He's over it. Scores! 50 goals in 39 games. The fans go wild. He's got 50 goals before anybody else got 30.
Wayne Gretzky is arguably the greatest to ever play the game, but that doesn't mean he's exempt from a bizarre moment on the ice. Here he is at play number 37. October 30th, 1997 featured a regular season game between the New York Islanders and the New York Rangers. Superstar Wayne Gretzky played with a misspelled jersey for the duration of the game. The Islanders won the contest 5-3, but the jersey didn't affect Gretzky. He still had an assist in the game.
Paul McLean has, it looks like, his twin brother.
Yeah, what is that? Lanny McDonald is two seats behind.
The gentleman that was sitting behind the bench, any comments on that?
I think my grandfather's in town, if he wasn't passed away already. Apparently, there's quite a resemblance. I hope he gets as much help as I get around town.
Jets go offside. However,
we're going to go again. But the shot went into the net after the whistle. That's never appreciated. And now we've got to go pile up along the boards. Look at the number of players going to the belly box.
Wow,
everybody coming over to the box.
We've got a sea of bodies in both. A round of minors for everybody. Treats everybody to a round of minors. I don't recall a moment I've ever seen a penalty box so congested.
Go to the bottom of the second in a 1-1 game. Here's defenseman Dennis Wideman, the right-hand shot, picking it up, moving in on Crawford, right up the middle. Fake stick hit. Oh, and he fell down as he tried to move around Crawford, didn't get all the way around him. And Crawford with his first NHL hit.
Your worst nightmare going in is you're going to separate your shoulder on a breakaway. But Dennis Wideman, he goes in and he tried to beat Crawford and he had him down and out. I think he tripped on his stick as Crawford tried to poke check the puck. Might have. He didn't do anything.
Puck is taken by McPhee and is shot wide to the left. Rick Green tries to hold it in. Now we've got something thrown out on the ice. Puck is picked up and cleared to center. Something out on the ice. It's a chicken. Somebody threw a live chicken on the ice. Play is continuing. It's a live chicken on the ice in the King's zone. I've heard of rubber chickens before in a hockey game, but not a live chicken. It has a blue napkin on it, so now they don't know what to do with it. Chicken sitting out on the ice. I've never seen this before in my life. Someone said it is a foul deed to do at a hockey game.
Battles it past Stapleton. The Leafs get it up on the wing. Kessel ran into Hainsey, but is able to get to the loose puck. Now carries it over the line, and Hainsey reached around. And a shot in wide of the goal, and waffles.
Waffles are on the ice again, whatever that means.
And Hamilton has to scramble back quickly. Under duress, Stone and empty net. Mark Stone across. Kyle Turris scores!
Turris finishes it off, and there's burgers everywhere. It's raining burgers out here. People are being selfish, just throwing the bun. Where's the meat?
And the Ottawa Senators get the regulation win they're looking for.
I think Curtis Lazar's having a little post-game snack right now. Hope there's not a weigh-in tomorrow morning.
Back to where the point for Pops. What's it go? Body goes sailing down in front. It went wide. And Tanguay for the Avalanche. Risky pass in front of his own goal. And now a Hawk player is injured.
That's Sullivan. And he's going to get a lot of those kind of
high sticks. You would think it would be an automatic for him, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
He was talking to a fan.
Tipped in by Amani. McGraw puts it up the boards. And again, it was tipped and it goes out of play.
There's the guy that was talking to Sullivan.
And he got hit in the head. And Sullivan said, how's that fit?
Exactly.
Nordiques down in the Sabres corner, powers his way through, sets it up for Wyshynski, shoots, he scores! And oh boy, did Raglan level out Malarchuk.
Just seconds before the end of the game, Rob Ray and a fan got into a fight in front of the Sabres bench. No charges were filed against Ray in the bizarre incident. Plenty more action on our countdown still to come. Keep it locked right here.
Scores! I wonder if they threw that up!
Over to Napier. Napier with the shot. Vernon out of the net to make the save. Vernon came out to challenge that time, as Grant Fuhr did in the second period on Steve Bozak. Oh, they score! Oh, Steve Smith, in attempting to get it out of his own zone, put it in the net.
There's the puck stopped by Grant Fuhr. Watch Smith. It comes out right in front of his net and tries to pass it through the middle. It hit Grant Fuhr and goes in.
Here's Getzlaff. Getzlaff with Perry streaking to the front of the net. Getzlaff puts it to the side of the net. Perry turns right out in front of Cup. Nobody there. It's headed to the empty net. Will it make it? Yes, it does. Corey Perry scores on his own goal from behind the Oilers' net.
Scramble in front here. Goes off of Dubnyk and down into the end.
And the Edmonton Oilers will see a six-game losing streak snapped. Inside for Eric. Eric Staal, who has the goal tonight. Lindholm just wide. Off the bench for Steve. He'll address it. His shot off Lindholm. It goes high. High in the air. Off Fleury. And in! Carolina has scored as they get the fortuitous bounce off the end wall. And the Kings are up by two.
I'm not sure Versteeg has scored a flukier goal than this. It actually goes off Crosby's stick. Boy, it hits just above the two and the 2-9 on Fleury. What a bounce. Off of Crosby, off the boards, maybe off the glass, off of Fleury, 2-0.
It's Phaneuf comes away with it. Gets hooked from behind but breaks out to center. Matt Foy has him tied up. Phaneuf's long shot sails wide. Look, he breaks the pane of glass and that'll be it for a while.
Well, just in the corner of the pane of glass that shatters.
Now there's less than 10 seconds to go in the period. Kiprasov plays it out of his net. Misses the puck, fans on it.
And now it's out of the trapezoid, so he couldn't go back and play it.
And Phaneuf clears it in. That's the end of the period. Can you believe it? For the second time in a period, he's broken another pane of glass.
Okay, you're not allowed to shoot it anymore. Tell Dion Phaneuf he's not allowed to shoot the puck anymore.
It's costing his team money. They had the Canadiens an empty net for a split second.
He just shattered the glass.
Oh, I can't believe what just happened. Doug Gilmour in slamming the door shattered a gigantic pane of glass down there. And had to actually work his way through the deep. Look at this. He slammed the door and it went poof when he sat down. Ho! He did about a split second what's going on, and then he just went back to the same demeanor that he had before he slammed the door.
Out of the penalty box comes Sutter, offside against the Canadiens, and now Hextall goes barreling out at one of the Canadiens, hitting high and hard. Chelios escorted to the bench where the Canadiens greet him, but there you see Ron Hextall frustrated, and now Dave Poulin is catching some some hits from one of the Canadians, so Samuelson moved in, and we have a real powder keg brewing here.
You bet.
And Hextall is being restrained by Gerard Gauthier from getting over toward Patrick Roy.
Hextall is also being challenged by Patrick Roy. Roy threw his stick down to this mascot and said, you want me, come over here.
Colburn now, trying to get it around Lucas Pisa. And a penalty coming up against Trevino as he trips up Colburn. Colburn back and forth, down low, out of the corner to Wideman, and he drifts one all the way down.
Oh, look at it! This is going to hit the net! The Calgary Flames put one in their own net!
Oh, boy. And as Wideman tries to go D to D, catches Raymond in a bad spot, and my goodness. If you're Calgary, you're thinking, are you kidding me? Could this possibly happen to us?
How many of these drawn-up plays actually go right according to Hoyle? I mean, a lot of it is, if we lose the draw, here's what happens. If we don't, let's see if we can't set this up.
But well, the Leafs have only won 34% of the faceoffs tonight as the Flames have dominated in that department. Let's see what happens here.
Stajan will take the faceoff. And a shot right on goal!
Look at this goal. Connery will shove it right back, and he puts it in his own net. He says, are you kidding me?
And around it's flicked by Ladd, and then went off of Coburn. On back to be taken by Campbell. Here's Campbell handing on to Kane again. Lots of head fakes there, trying to shake Demon. Threw one in front. Oh, my, it rattled around, and it kicked on back, and then scored! We saw no light, we saw no signal, and we're not sure if they've sent a signal of a goal yet, but they are celebrating at the other end of the ice. What chaos! Word has gotten to the Blackhawks what you have just seen. One of the more unusual finishes, but it's a goal. The Stanley Cup to the Chicago Blackhawks. No light, no signal just yet, but it is in fact over that line, and the Stanley Cup has been won by Chicago, as you see how this all happened. Well, why not? Why not a chaotic finish to all of this?
Talking about not much room for the great players in this series, but as Bob Hartley said, and Peter Forsberg just illustrated, the great players make room for themselves. Here's a chance, Eiserman! Oh, he just couldn't finish it off as Wall was down. Eiserman in front again, another chance, and a big stop! Dropped it, and Detroit scores first for the first time.
Patrick Waugh just got caught hot-dogging. Believe me, he was going to give it the how do you do, and he dropped the puck.
Now Eisenman's late getting out of the corner because he just gets behind the defense. Now watch Waugh, he's got it. And then he drops it, and he thinks he's got it in his glove, and I'm not so sure he was giving it the old, look what I got.
We're over halfway through our countdown with the best yet to come. Don't go anywhere.
Scores!
On a broken stick!
Welcome back to the NHL Network's countdown of the 50 most bizarre moments in NHL history.
Well, here we go. It's going to be Norton and Downey. Downey falls before they even get to it. As Norton and Downey just kind of wait for each other at center ice. Downey is in the pose made popular in the 1920s. And so far, this has been a lot of the evil eye and not much else.
Yeah, that's about it. And now the linesmen just step in. And this started, though, off to the
get done with it.
And the linesmen are going to step in here. And both will go off here. That'll be for naught.
And, well, they didn't actually go.
they did get a good look at each other.
The other way, Semin and Ovechkin. Semin! Fakes, trying to slide it underneath. Bellicent, he went into the net and knocked it off. And Stahl gets up and goes after Semin.
Oh,
Oh boy.
Simmons gonna get thrown out of the game, I think.
Whoops.
That is not a National Hockey League fighter. I'm gonna slap you silly, kid.
That was different. Something you don't often see.
I'm gonna slap you silly.
There's a puck sitting on the back of the net. I don't think anyone's aware of that.
Okay.
Now there's two pucks on the ice, and the players are going, what the heck is going on? I want to know who put the puck on the back of the net. You can see the puck on the back of the net. The puck goes in behind the Ranger net, and now Winchester goes to fish it off the back, but that wasn't the puck that they were originally playing with.
Oh, man. They pull out all the stops. You've heard of the hidden ball trick. It's a variation of that.
11 for 36 for the captain. He's had a heavy game here tonight. Let's see if he can do it. Doan comes in. Scored! A broken stick!
That is as greasy as a goal as you're ever gonna see. And it couldn't happen to a better guy. Shane Doan just rips it. And maybe it was the broken blade that almost took off the head of Anderson.
Happy celebration, Shane Doan. A shootout goal off a broken stick. Anders Lindback injured prior to the warm-up, so that is Nathan Schoenfeld, Jim's kid. He was signed to an amateur tryout agreement prior to tonight's game to be the emergency backup. Played club hockey at Arizona State. And the new NHL rule is that every team must provide the NHL with a name of a goalie in their market for this exact reason, in case they need an emergency backup. So he is backing up here tonight.
I gotta know, where were you when you got the call and what time was it?
It was about 6 o'clock. I was at home with my wife. We were bathing our twin boys. And I told her, I said, I'm sorry, I gotta leave. I got the call.
On November 16th, 1997, and trailing by 3 goals late in the game, Colorado goalie Patrick Waugh did something we've never, ever seen before. Waugh stick-handled around Wayne Gretzky and carried the puck across center ice. Waugh would be assessed a minor penalty for that play, as it remains one of the strangest, albeit impressive, moments in NHL history.
So Davidson spins it around the board, but not out. Islanders have Park and Rieger up front. That's Davidson on the intercept and the clear. Back on D with Meyer.
And I like that they, oh, there's a goal! It bounces right by Toskala. Oh, you want to talk about a bad infield. A big hop. Bounces over the left pad of Vesa Toskala. A 200-foot goal.
Yet controlled by Shepard, over to Sprock, and it's Shepard, and
this is the Avalanche's first look at the Rats. My goodness.
Well, this is the heaviest.
Oh.
They added more staff for this game tonight. 25 people are out there gathering them in. The strangest thing they said they've picked up in these playoffs, it's been a box of Decon, which is a rat killer. They actually did have, as you will have with any spontaneous thing, somebody who actually turned loose a real one out there, and they very carefully got it coaxed into one of the buckets that they use. After the break, we'll unveil our countdown's top 10 bizarre moments in NHL history. Stay tuned.
Roll on.
the game of hockey.
We've seen our fair share of spectacular goalie saves and performances over the years, but next on our countdown are two of the most bizarre goalie moments in NHL history. The 1928 Stanley Cup Finals featured the Montreal Maroons and the New York Rangers, who were making their first finals appearance. During game two of the series, an eye injury forced the Rangers' starting goalie out of the game, and he would not return. Head coach and general manager Lester Patrick inserted himself into the game in relief. Patrick saved 18 of 19 shots as the Rangers won 2-1 in overtime, and they would eventually go on to win the series 3-2 in a best-of-five format. At over 44 years old, Patrick is and still remains the oldest player to ever play in a Stanley Cup Finals game.
Bork pops it back in, 1:28 left. And Hextall able to clear it out. Boy, he could score a goal sometimes in a situation like this. Hextall is so strong in clearing. Traps it, here he goes, bidding for one. Here's the clear, here it is, he scores! Hextall scored a goal on the empty net, and you can see that, he is so strong at it.
But this is the first time in my 40 years being around this game that I've actually seen a goaltender do that.
No goaltender has done in the National Hockey League what Hextall just did. Boy, he picked the corner.
Picked the corner, yeah.
1952 was a historic year for the Detroit Red Wings. The Wings won 8 straight playoff games, beating the Toronto Maple Leafs and then the Montreal Canadiens to win the Stanley Cup Final. It was also during this run of victories that an infamous tradition was born. As the legend goes, 2 Detroit men threw an octopus onto the ice during the 4th and final game of the Stanley Cup Finals. The 8 tentacles are a symbol of the 8 victories it took Detroit to win the championship. And the good luck charm has stuck ever since.
After the point man, it's Jágr. Dani Gomez in the ring. Jágr again, walking. Shooting one wide of Brodeur. Played this way by Gomez. Got Gomez turned. Thinks about it, one-timer. Oh, it's blocked in front. Shanahan let it fly. Jágr again holding onto it. Gomez with a shot taken wide of Brodeur. Goes out of the reach of Brendan Shanahan. Gomez is flying. He sets up Jágr. Jágr for Gomez holding onto it out in front. They score! The guy you talked about, Sean Avery.
Call it tactics. Call it antics. Call it effective in the end. This is unbelievable. I've never seen anything like this. And then the worst kind of payback. The next foray into the offensive zone. Avery gets down to business and makes them pay with the goal. Oh my, oh my, oh my.
Game 3 of the 1975 Stanley Cup Finals comes in at number 6 on our list. Play was halted due to a flying bat inside Buffalo Memorial Auditorium until Sabres center Jim Lorenz whacked it out of the air. Flyers forward Rick McLeish then carried the bat off the ice in one of hockey's truly bizarre moments. After the break, we crack our countdown's top 5 moments, featuring fan interaction like you've never seen before.
Oh, into the stands goes Ty Domi.
Domi actually initiated all that.
Welcome back to the NHL Network's countdown of the 50 most bizarre moments in NHL history.
A stick measurement has been called. It's the stick of Marty McSorley.
Marty McSorley, if he uses an illegal stick, which he did, there's no excuse for that.
1:45 remaining in the third, and the Canadiens have 6 skaters against 4. Muller back of the net with it. Blake in there, hit his man. Desjardins ready. Schneider ready. Desjardins, no shot. On the outside, Desjardins shot, goal! They have tied it.
Oh, into the stands goes Ty Domi. The glass knocked out. A fan is jumping. Kevin Collins is in the middle of it. Now Kevin Collins trying to get the fan off of Ty Domi.
This is a first.
Kevin Collins breaks up, fights in the penalty box, too. The fan jumped into the penalty box area.
I think he slipped over the glass. I don't think he had any intentions of going in there.
Let's see if he squirts the fan right here. Oh, the glass fell.
There's Kevin Collins. Kevin Collins may have gotten the worst of that, but oh yeah, tied Domi in. Got some shots in.
Domi actually initiated all that.
But he's frustrated. You want to take that frustration out on somebody, he takes it out on the fan. The fan taking some swings at him, and then the glass gives out. He ends up in the penalty box with him, and you got all kinds of things breaking loose.
Locates Bergeron, and Stu Barnes stripped him. Steffen's attempt at the empty net hit a body. That's why there's no icing. Maybe one last gasp here for the Oilers. Bergeron fans on a pass. Steffen steals, and he'll ice it. Oh, at least I thought he was gonna, until he blew it. That's unbelievable. Here come the Oilers the other way, and Hemsky's loose. Hemsky, he scored! Can you believe what we just saw?
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever seen. And I don't know, I've been around the game 25 years at the pro level. That is unbelievable.
I cannot believe what I just witnessed with my own two eyes.
Dory, back of the net. Into the corner. Off the board. And Harrison and Hemsky.
In the midst of all that fracas, Bill, somebody, one of the Ranger players, threw Bernie Perron's face mask up into the crowd, and I doubt very much if he'll get it back, and I just wonder if the goaltenders carry a spare mask. I would imagine they do.
4:42, they're still asking for the mask, but I don't think they're going to get it.
What a moment that was, coming in at number two on our list. Before getting to our top play on the countdown, let's take a look back at how we got here.
Right into the net, you can see the puck laying on the top of his pants, on his jersey, in the net. Shaw with the header.
Well, a nice header by Grips. He reached up to the side of his helmet.
That was absolutely bizarre. And
Sean Feld said, you can't suspend me, simply, I'm gonna coach. And they said, you coach, we don't referee.
Look out.
Hacky sack, right off the crossbar and into the net. He did, he threw it right in his own goal.
He threw it in his own net.
Watch this, one, and he hit it in again. It should be no goal. You gotta take that back.
Fake the legs! Oh, Malik went between his legs!
I've never seen that in my life.
That was something.
Oh, the rivalry's back, Sam.
I don't think I've ever seen that happen before.
Wow. I don't recall a moment I've ever seen a penalty box so congested.
I think he tripped on his stick. Someone said it is a foul deed to do in a hockey game.
The waffles are on the ice again, whatever that means.
I haven't figured that out either.
And there's burgers everywhere. It's raining burgers out here.
There's the guy that was talking to Sullivan. And Sullivan said, how's that feel?
Exactly. Oh, boy. Of Crosby, off the boards, maybe off the glass, off of Fleury, 2-0.
Tell Dion Phaneuf he's not allowed to shoot the puck anymore.
Costing his team money. He slammed the door and it went poof.
We have a real powder keg brewing here.
You bet.
The Calgary Flames put one of their own bets.
Scores! I wonder if they threw that up.
One of the more unusual finishes, but it's a goal. The Stanley Cup to the Chicago Blackhawks.
He's got it, and then he drops it.
Well, they didn't actually go. They did get a good look at each other. That was different. Something you don't often see.
Slap you silly.
You've heard of the hit the ball trick. A variation of that.
Scores! On a broken stick!
I said, I'm sorry, I gotta leave. I got the call.
I've never seen that in my life.
That was something.
I have to be honest.
Oh, there's a goal! It bounces right by Toscala.
This is the Avalanche's first look
at the Rats.
I cannot believe what I just witnessed with my own two eyes.
He scores! Hextall scored a goal on the empty net.
Call it tactics, call it antics. This is unbelievable. I've never seen anything like this.
If he uses an illegal stick, which he did.
Now Kevin Collins trying to get the fan off of Ty Domi.
This is a first.
Stephen steals and he'll ice it. Or at least I thought he was gonna. Can you believe what we just saw?
4:42, they're still asking for the mask, but I don't think they're gonna get it.
What can possibly top that? It's been a fun countdown, from 50 all the way down to number 2. Our number 1 moment takes us to Madison Square Garden in 1979, with the Boston Bruins taking on the New York Rangers.
Up to Esposito, one side, in alone. Cheever saves! Esposito behind everybody, moved right in, Rob, and Cheever's made the stop. You would not believe that finish. Esposito walked in all alone, smashes his stick and breaks it as Jerry Cheevers goes Esposito.
McNabb's going up to grab somebody about 7 or 8 rows up.
Well, this is too bad that after the game is over, it gets out of hand like this. And you got to worry about a spectator.
Well, the Bruins are at a decided disadvantage, Fred, with those skates, and somebody could get seriously hurt.
Oh, this does the game no good at all.
That does it for our countdown of the 50 most bizarre moments in NHL history. From all of us here at NHL Network, I'm Jameson Coyle. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.